So today I am going to try this poppin' cookin' sushi candy thing. I went to the Korean supermarket and I saw this and I was like, okay, what is this? And I read the box and I was like, make your own sushi candy. And I was like, okay, I'll try it out. And I thought it would be like a really funny thing to try this out on a video. So here I am. This is not a sponsor, by the way. I'm just gonna open this now. Let's see. How do you open it? Oh, found it. So you're just gonna open it up. Inside, there's this little plastic packaging thing. Just gonna put the box aside. I also have my water, by the way. So, not a sponsor either. Aw, so cute. There's this little thing over here. Okay, I'm gonna try so hard not to drop anything. Okay, so inside there's like more little packets of things. It's like all this stuff. I don't know what this is, but I'm guessing this is something to like build the sushi for. And then there's all these packets. I will put them aside. And then we have this spoon. I don't even know if this is gonna taste good, guys, but I'll try it out. I have no idea what this is either. I think this is a dropper. Okay, so are there any instructions? Oh, they're right here. Fill the oval depression one. Oh, found it. The oval depression one. And then with water. Okay, so I'm gonna fill this up with water, I'm guessing. So, okay. Then add the powder from the blue packet. Stir until thick, like cooked rice. Blue packet, blue packet, blue packet. I found it, guys. I'm so proud. Apparently, we're supposed to mix this. Do I add all of it? Should I add all of it? Is that too risky? I'll add until it's like enough, or maybe all of it. Ooh, guys, look at that. Mixy mixy. Come get your sushi. Let's just put the whole thing in. Beautiful. It smells fruity, actually. Like a fruit candy. Okay, I don't know how I feel about that taste, but it does taste how it like smells, but it's got a weird texture to it. Step two, add water to line on the side. Line on the side, what is that? Add water up to the line on the side in the spiral section. Spiral, then add powder from the yellow packet. Okay, so the spiral side is, I'm hoping this won't fall, this side right here. So I'm gonna add yellow, yes, the yellow packet, and water first. You always add water first, guys. Okay, is this yellow? I hope this is, yeah. Omelet candy powder. That's cool. Was that too much water? This might end up as a fail. Okay, so let's just mix this in. This omelet looks like an uncooked egg. Hold on, let me just show you guys a bit. Let me just tilt the camera. There's that, and it looks kind of suspicious. It looks kind of too watery because I do not know how to do this right. Wait 3 minutes until firm. Oh, it's supposed to dry. Whew! Okay, I am not doomed after all. Step three, make tuna. Add water up to line on side in wavy section. Okay, and then add powder from the red packet. Mix, spread, and flatten. Okay, so it's like the other one. Red packet. Red packet. Wait. Red packet? This is not red, guys. This is pink, but it says red packet, but I'll just call it a pink packet. Add water first, of course. So, add a little bit of water and pour it in. This could be like an educational thing for kids. Like, hey, why does this substance change? And then you learn about it, right? Yeah, okay, so this one also has the same consistency as the omelet. So we're gonna have to wait a bit so it will firm. Guys, I'm not the best at this. I put some of the red candy onto the rice. Oh well, things happen. Interesting taste. Step 4, make dried seaweed. Spread out the black candy to match the shape and size of the packing pouch. The packing pouch? What is that? What? I have no idea what that is. Oh, it just popped. I have no idea what the packing pouch is, but I'm gonna guess it's that little extra area in here that is right in front of the red and yellow areas. Okay, it smells like blueberry. Like, guys, it smells really good. Okay, so this looks like it's about the size of this. Okay, perfect. Step 5, make salmon roe. Add water up to lines on sides in sections A and B. So let's just put the water in for A and B. Add powder from the green packet to section A. So I have the green packet and now I'm gonna cut it and then I'm gonna open it and add it to section A. It's clear. Add powder from the orange packet to section B and mix well. Use dropper to slowly add mixture B to mixture A. Okay, so I'm just gonna mix this in a bit. I spilled again, guys. Add powder from the orange packet to section B. Oh, it's pink. Ooh, that's pretty. Let's mix this up a bit. Very gently, so we don't have to spill again. So it looks like this. That's the blood orange thing. Mix well, use dropper. Okay, we have the dropper. To slowly add mixture B to mixture A. Be careful not to mix liquids together. Mixture B to mixture A. What is this doing? That's so weird. Oh my gosh. That's such a weird texture. Oh my gosh, guys. Okay. I have to show you guys this. You see this, right? And you see that? So when I do the dropper, hold on, and then I drop it in, it makes this weird texture. It's so cool. I don't know, I'm really fascinated by it. Excuse the little disturbing noises. Okay. Well, now we have our salmon roe, and it is the most fascinating thing that I have seen in this little thing. Now this is all done. How to make omelet sushi and tuna sushi is next. So you form a ball from the rice. Ooh, honey, this is messy. And then you cut the omelet and tuna in half. Okay. Good thing I brought napkins because I'm gonna need this. Ooh. Oh, that is a funny texture. Ooh, okay. So the omelet is ready. I will cut that in half. Flip the halves over and put them on the rice balls. How cute. I have a little rice ball. And then I'm gonna get a bit of the omelet. Okay, it's dripping. Guys, my first little sushi. How adorable. I'll just put it on this napkin. I hope it doesn't stick, but there it is, guys. I'm so proud of myself. Is this done, man? Oh, it's done. It's done, guys. Okay, so we're gonna cut this in half too. We're gonna make another rice ball. So now that we have our little rice ball, we are going to cut out the tuna that we already cut out. And then we're gonna place it on top, I believe. Is this too much rice? That is way too much rice, honey. Okay, so we're gonna just take a bit of the rice out. Look at there. That's a decent amount. Aww, how adorable. Ugh. Guys, I made a toonie. I have this tuna sushi. There we go. This tuna sushi. And it looks so red, so cute. I'm gonna make two more. So two of each. So I will just go ahead and do that first. Okay, I officially have four sushi total, and very messy hands in the process. I'm gonna set that aside so it doesn't be a distraction. Now let's figure out how to make the other sushi. How to make salmon roe sushi. From a rice ball, wrap the rice ball in dried seaweed. Oh, that's what it's for, okay. Fill dropper half full of water and add to section one. Section one? Honey, section one is full with rice. Add powder from the brown packet and mix well, and then you'll have soy sauce. Okay, so I'm gonna use the place where I put the seaweed in for the soy sauce. So we're gonna put this in here and then we're gonna wrap this up. So that it sticks together. Oh, that is so funny. Guys, you pick this up and it doesn't become watery anymore. It's like that. Oh my gosh. You are a weird texture. That is way too much. That is way too much too. Is there like a little guy that I can use? That looks really cool. So there is my salmon roe, as you can see. Now I'm gonna just place it down so it won't be messy. And yeah, that is the final product, and that is actually so cool. Now I am going to try and taste it. So here we go. It is stuck! Okay, there we go. We're gonna have a bite of the egg roll sushi. I believe this is called tamago. I believe. I'm not sure though. I don't know how I feel about that. Okay, so the rice. I don't like how the rice tastes. But this is pretty decent. I don't know what flavor it is, but it tastes okay. The rice though. It's an awkward taste. Okay, now we're gonna try the tuna sushi, if it would ever not stick. The tuna has a really strong taste, like strawberry. Okay, I'm really curious about this little guy. I'm also kind of scared about this, but this one is the best one so far. I actually really like this one, mostly because this thing right here, the seaweed, it tastes like a candy I've had before. I think this is blueberry flavored because I wouldn't like it if it was grape. But I hope you guys like this video. It's kind of just a weird, random, fun video that I decided to do. So comment and subscribe if you want to. I hope you guys have a terrific day. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye.